Good morning, students. As you know, we have just completed our first chapter of biology, that is cell. Cell is the fundamental unit of life. Now, moving ahead, when the cells combine together, they form a higher level of organization that is known as tissue. Tissue is a group of cells having similar origin, structure, and function. And study of tissue is histology. Study of cell was cytology, we discussed, and study of tissues is called histology. In this chapter, we will study plant tissue and animal tissue. Plant tissue, plants do not move, they are non-mobile, they are stationary. Most of the plant tissues are dead. When we will study plant tissue in detail, you will come to know that generally the plant tissues are dead. The dead cells provide strength or mechanical strength to the plant. As you know, plants, they don't have the skeletal system. So who will provide the strength to the plants? That is their dead cells or the dead tissues. And at the same time, same thing we have discussed about the cell wall. The function of cell wall, which is made up of cellulose, it provides rigidity and strength to the plant. Same way, the dead cells, what is the function of dead cell, which are present in large number in plants? To provide the strength, as they don't have the skeletal system. So we know plants, they have to bear up the harsh environmental condition, they have to stand outside, they are non-mobile, and how they are able to face the and withstand the harsh environmental condition? Because of the presence of cell wall, which is made up of cellulose. And second is, most of their cells are dead, and these dead cells provide strength or mechanical strength to the plant. If the most of the cells are dead, it means they need less maintenance or less energy for their maintenance as compared to the animal cell, animal tissue, where most of the cells are living and a lot of energy is wasted in the maintenance of those living cells. Some of the plant tissue keep on dividing throughout the plant life. So these are the characteristic feature of plant tissue. Now, next question arises, why tissue are important? Tissues are important because we get the higher level of organization. If we see levels of organization in biology, it starts from the cell. Cell combined together to form tissue. Then group of tissue is organ. Organ group is organ system. In this way, we can say that this tissue provides us higher level of organization. If there is no tissue system, we can't get the higher level of organization. So that is very important for increasing the complexity of the life system, life forms. And division of work, labor is work, division of work is possible in case of tissue system. As you have seen, in case of cell, single cellular organism like amoeba, paramecium, single cell perform all the functions. But if there is tissue system and higher level of organization, then we have got different organs or tissues for performing different functions. So division of work can be there. Work can be divided. Then efficiency or the capacity of the organism increases. As compared to the unicellular, multicellular organism, they are more efficient. So we can say tissue provides us the efficiency of the organism, or it enhances the efficiency of the or the capacity of the organism. Then higher survival value is there. Comparing it with the unicellular organism, their lifespan is lesser. But in case of multicellular organism, their lifespan is more. So survival value is more. If there is complexity increased, if their higher level of organization we have attained, it means survival value will be more. And overload of a single cell can be decreased. How the overload of single cell can be decreased? Because now in case of tissue system, we have got division of work, division of labor. So single cell, it has like other cells are also there, tissues are also there to perform the functions. Now next topic is types of plant tissue. There are three types of plant tissue: meristematic tissue, which is also called meristems or permanent tissue, and third one is protective tissue. Meristematic tissue helps in the growth and development of the plant. Permanent tissue, they have got n number of functions. When we will read in detail, you come to know about permanent tissue. And third is protective tissue, as its name clarifies that it is for the protection of the plants. In this flowchart or the concept map, you can see plant tissue is divided into three categories. Number one tissue is meristematic. Number two is called permanent tissue. Now meristematic is further divided into apical, lateral and intercalary. Apical, lateral and intercalary. And you can learn it by ALI, a mnemonic ALI. Apical, lateral and intercalary, ALI. Meristematic tissue we will study today. Rest we will study later on. Third is the protective tissue. Either you can make it here only, or because it is considered to be the part of simple permanent tissue, so you can keep it with simple permanent tissue, your choice. Otherwise, you can keep it here also, protective tissue. Okay, so it's better because it is the part of simple permanent tissue, so keep it in that category only. So today we will study about meristems or meristematic tissue. Under this, we have got three subdivisions: apical, lateral and intercalary, and how to learn ALI by the mnemonics ALI. Now meristematic tissue, these are very important because of this tissue the plant is able to grow. So they have got the power of cell division. They divide rapidly. The cells of this tissue, they divide rapidly. They have got the power of cell division. That's why they are responsible for growth and development of the plant. The cells are very active, highly active. Then cells in these tissues can divide and form new cells. It is also called parent tissue, means the protective tissue and the permanent tissue. It also arises from the meristematic tissue. Or you can say, when meristematic tissue at a certain point of time, when it stops dividing, then it becomes mature and it gets transformed into permanent tissue or the protective tissue. यही वाला टिश्यू बाद में मैच्योर होके परमानेंट और प्रोटेक्टिव टिश्यू बन जाता है. सो दैट्स व्हाई मेरिस्टेमेटिक टिश्यू इज कॉल्ड पेरेंट टिश्यू. व्हेन इट स्टॉप्स डिवाइडिंग फॉर सम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम, इट कीप्स डिवाइडिंग, बट एट अ सर्टेन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम व्हाट हैपेंस दैट इट स्टॉप्स डिवाइडिंग एंड इट गेट्स डिफरेंशिएटेड और इट गेट्स मॉडिफाइड इनटू परमानेंट और द प्रोटेक्टिव टिश्यू. एज इट गिव्स राइज टू दीज टू टाइप्स ऑफ टिश्यू, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड द पेरेंट टिश्यू. It is found on other those regions or those areas of the plant which grows, like the tip of the stem. It is present on the tip of the roots. So wherever the plant shows the growth or growing regions has the meristematic tissue basically. Now types of meristems or meristematic tissue. First is apical meristem. Apical meristem, it is present on the growing tips of the stem and roots, and it increases the length of the plant. Because it is present at the tips, because apic means tip, and it is present, this type of tissue is present at the tip. If you see one plant, you can see at the tip, what kind of meristem is present? Tip of the stem, मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू. विच मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू? एपिकल मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू, और यू कैन से एपिकल मेरिस्टम. एंड इट इंक्रीजेज द लेंथ. दिस इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इंक्रीजिंग द लेंथ ऑफ द प्लांट और हाइट. प्लांट अटेन्स हाइट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मेरिस्टम. सेकेंड इज लेटरल मेरिस्टम. लेटरल मीन्स साइड्स. इट इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द लेटरल साइड ऑफ द स्टेम और रूट एंड इंक्रीजेज द थिकनेस. देन थर्ड वन इज द इंटरकैलरी मेरिस्टम. इट इज प्रेजेंट एट द नोड्स और द बेस ऑफ द लीव्स एंड इंक्रीजेज द लेंथ बिटवीन द नोड्स. दिस स्लाइड विल बी क्लियर by looking or viewing one more diagram which is shown here. You can see in this picture, you can see first one is the apical meristem. Apical meristem is present at the tips. Basically it is present at the tips. Apical meristem is present at the tips, tip of the stem and tip of the root. If, for example, root is there, so it is present at the tip. And it increases the length. It is responsible for increasing the length of the stem or the length of the plant or even the length of the root. So, whenever somebody asks you where the apical meristem is present, apical meristem is present at the tip of the stem and tip of the roots, and it is responsible for the lengthwise increase in the growth. Now, second one is the lateral meristem. Lateral meristem is present on the sides here, and it increases the thickness or the girth. Thickness is called girth of the stem. Okay, the stem becomes trunk because of the lateral meristem. Okay, in younger plant you see the stem. So stem attains the thickness, and that is because of the presence of lateral meristem. And third one, this one is the second one. This is responsible for giving the width or the girth, or you can say thickness, to the stem. And third is intercalary meristem. It is present at the nodes, basically here. Node means the place from where the stem or the leaf arise. And the distance between two nodes is known as internode. So this distance is internode. Here to here is internode. And these are the nodes. And this intercalary meristem is present at the nodes and the internode. So now moving back to the previous slide. Now everything will be clear. Now you know the location of apical meristem at the tips, intercalary meristem at the nodes and internodes, and lateral meristem. Lateral means sideways, at the sides of the plant or the stem. Now coming back to the same, that is the meristematic tissue. Apical meristem, it is present at the tips of the stem and root, and it increases the plant lengthwise. Okay, and lateral meristem, it is present at the lateral side of the stem and root also, and they increase the thickness of the stem and root. It means it is responsible for this kind of growth, that is the sideways growth, you can say, or the transverse growth. Now next one is the intercalary meristem, present at the internodes or base of the leaves and increase the length between the node. The length, this one is the node. Node is the place from where the leaves or the branches arise, and internode is the distance between two node. And this one, intercalary meristem, is present at the base of the leaves, or it is present in the internodal area, and it increases the length of the internode, or you can say indirectly it also increases the plant lengthwise. So this is the role of meristematic tissue. And how to remember it? By Ali. A-L-I. A stands for apical, L for lateral, and I for intercalary. A for lengthwise increase, that is apical, lateral for the increase in thickness, and intercalary is for increasing the length of the internodes. Thank you very much. Revise well.